Also, the other thing you're going to notice is that the cape, the cord is long enough for you to jack that into your drums, and it's thick enough too. And he's made sure that he double enforced it at the bottom so that it's not very easy to rip the wire apart. Okay, and it comes right out of a convenient hole that's in the drum, so that when you connect this, the wire itself is going to compress like so, and the drum's going to sit in there, so you don't have to worry about snapping your wire. But let's talk about what the most incredible thing to me is about this drum. And Daniel, from what I believe, what he told me, he does not play drums at all, okay, is the way that his sensor is mounted in this drum. Now, I'm not going to tell you how it's mounted because of the fact of the matter that I am not here to give away his trade secrets. I am going to tell you this, though. If you are a drummer, you're going to know exactly what I mean. If you buy an electronic drum kit, whether it's Roland, whether it's Yamaha, whether it's Pentek or beyond, there is a way that they mount their sensor. Now, the way that a real electronic drum company mounts their sensor is that so your stick never comes in contact with the sensor at all. This is the other thing that he has right. On most other mesh kits or other drum kits I've played, your stick is coming in direct contact with the sensor. I do not care how much foam you have around that sensor is delicate. So every time you are beating on it with a stick, it makes that sensor weak. Therefore, you will start to experience drop notes, and then sooner or later, the sensor is just going to give out. That is not the case with the Metal Workz. The sensor is mounted in such a way that no matter where you hit this drum at, your stick will never ever come in contact with a piece of foam that has a sensor underneath it or the sensor directly. What that does is that improves the life of your sensor. I'm not going to tell you that sensors never go out, because they do. If you own a Pentek, Roland, whatever, sometimes your sensors will go out. Therefore, Pentek is the only company in the world that I know of that does back their drums up for life, and they replace those. But however, I'm not saying the sensor won't go out, but I am saying that it's going to have a longer life because you're not directly smacking that on top of there, okay? The other thing I like about it is the actual rim. If you can see this, the rim, there virtually isn't one, so you have a little bit more space to work with. Other drums I have, even the Rock Band kit, you're always smacking a lot of rim. You won't smack a ton of rim on this because you have a bigger surface here in the middle. There is some play videos that I have that's going to come up with these that I haven't had time to post. So that's why I've selected the other videos that you may have already seen go by, but I haven't put them up yet, that of these drums being played. Evasity is one of them that actually FC'd one of the Guns N' Roses songs on these. These things are a testament of themselves and for themselves. I don't think you can go any better mesh head than anything else. Let me answer the question, because I always get it. Do I want to go with these, or do I want to go with Ions? Well, here's the deal. If you can afford Ions and you still want them, go with the Ions. But if I didn't have Ions already, I would go for the Metal Workz. The Ion Drum Rocker, it's $299 if you get the whole entire set, and they just released the Drum Rocker Core that is $199. However, the mesh heads, the Metal Workz mesh heads, is going to cost you $129.99, which is on a special right now. Okay, after the special, I believe that they go to $149.99. Now let's talk about the price real quick, because I'm already going to hear it and I'm going to do what I really don't want to do, and that's call to the company, but this is the question I'm going to get, so I'm going to answer it. Here's the question. All right, Cena, cool, they look good, but good with mods just dropped their prices down to $99.99. Why should I pay $129 for these, or if I missed the $129, why should I pay the $149? Good question, so I'm going to answer it. As a consumer of buying musical instruments or anything else, I feel that if a company continues dropping prices on their equipment, it says something about the product. If you believe that your product is worth $160 and you've been selling that product at $160 forever, why would you continue to drop it? Okay? That just makes to real consumers or parents, since I talk to a lot of kids, I'm talking to you how your parents look. They look at the parent like, wow, you know, we had a price drop this month, we had a price drop last month, we got a price drop this month, what's wrong with this product? You get what you pay for. These drums are worth $129 for these reasons. The customer service that is behind them. The construction that went into them. The money that went into these to make these for you so that you have a better, reliable kit. You can't go wrong with them. The 7 times stronger mesh that he's using on here. You know you're not going to have a problem. The warranties alone. Let me remind you again. Lifetime on the frame. 6 months on the mesh. 5 years on the sensors. No one else is going to touch that. The placement of how his sensors are in this drum. This makes all of these $129. So I'm going to give you what David McClam, a.k.a. Cena's, shopping philosophy is. And maybe you guys can get with this, and maybe you can't. And this is a small story. My wife and I, when we first met and got married 7 years ago, then after the first year that we were together, we had to go buy a new stereo. My wife is one of those people that likes to shop really cheap. But my whole thing is, if you go today and you buy an entertainment center or a stereo for your entertainment center that costs you, let's just say for round figure, $200, that $200 stereo may only last you 6 months to a year, or if there's a 3-year warranty, you may get 3 years out of it, but right after 3 years, I guarantee you it breaks. But if you go and you spend a little bit more money, let's just say $2,000, and you buy what you necessarily need, you may have the stereo for many years to come. Well, I own a Yamaha surround sound stereo that we bought 5.5 years ago, that I worked at Best Buy at the time, that was originally should have been $4,000 for the unit itself that I bought, and $10,000 for the wire, but I walked out being an employee paying $1,500 for it, and that stereo is still ticking 5.5 years later. Case in point about the Metal Workz versus everything else. If you're willing to put the money into something good the first time, you're not going to have to go back and rebuy that same item again, either saving you money or allowing you to put money somewhere else. I'm going to go on record in closing and state something that I have never done before when it comes to anybody else. I'll wholeheartedly put myself behind this, and I'm calling the Metal Workz drum the official drums of Cena's Corner. To prove my point on that, if you go to my new website, cenascorner.com, you're going to see that the Metal Workz drums is even featured in the banner of my website. People, I have never seen a drum kit that was made by a third party as good as this one. I have my questions a little bit about version 1, but I gave him a good review because the product was good. But I have no question at all about version 2, and since he's taking care of all of you, the customer, I further have no more questions. You can pick these up right now at rockbandparts.com. Comes with all the warranties that I told you. There's a big thing when you go there, $129.99. There's a link to that in this site. Go check these out. If you want to spend and go cheap, then these are not the drums for you. But if you're willing to put the $129 into this for the limited time, or the $149, if you missed the $129, I guarantee you, you will not go wrong. All right, guys, so that's been the review of the Metal Workz Drums version 2. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And another review is coming up real soon. So until next time, peace, love, keep rocking out, and we're going to catch you guys next time.